They give them a new future. They give them a vision of the world the way it can be. And that's why you came here today with your children and your students. You're showing them the world that we need to have. You are exercising your constitutional right to petition the government for redress of grievances. That is the most basic constitutional right that we have in a democracy. And others who don't vote for education continue to get re-elected, what does that say about the commitment of our communities to get the money we need for our schools? We have this year an election at the national level that will change the future tremendously. We have other elections at the local level that also will change the future. And what I was going to ask each of you to do, because you don't need to talk to me, I will give you every dime you need to educate our students, but I can't until I have a few more votes from people who have taken a pledge not to raise taxes. That pledge is from Washington. It has nothing to do with us living in California. You need to go and talk to anyone who is in office and has signed that pledge and tell them, you need to put us first. You need to put Californians first. You don't need to sign a pledge sent to you by somebody back in Washington, D.C. Because their commitment is not to the students and the teachers and the families in California. You need to represent us first. And if you are a candidate, you need to take a pledge to us in California to support us getting the money we need for our schools and our teachers and our students. If you are going to represent us, this is what you need to do to every candidate running for office. You need to say, will you take a pledge for our students? Will you take a pledge for our teachers? Will you take a pledge for the future of California that we will have the education we need to move ahead and continue to be the world's eighth largest economy? That's the pledge they need to take. That requires a supermajority to pass a budget. The other two states are Rhode Island and Arkansas. Two of the smallest states in the country. Why is the eighth largest economy in the world held hostage to six Republican votes? That's a broken system. It needs to be fixed. And every time we give a tax cut to somebody like the yacht owners, then we take away the tax credit from people like the teachers. Why are the Republicans more concerned about the yacht owners than our students? Why are they willing to take away the tax credit for teachers to go out and spend their own money on school books and research papers, and yet we give a tax credit to a millionaire buying a new boat? Something has to change. And you need, I'm sorry to tell you this because I know you're all struggling. Gasoline is $4 a gallon. I know you're working more and earning less. But this is, and I know that the Iraq War is taking away the dollars that we need here at home. But what you are doing today is exactly what needs to be done, and you need to take this message to the businesses that need the skilled, educated workers in the coming years and say, California, you say you don't approve of taxes, how will you feel when you can't hire employees to do the jobs you need to have done here in California? Instead, they're hearing, I took a pledge, no new taxes. We need to tell them, no, you need to take a pledge to honor the commitment you have as an elected representative to our families, our students, our teachers, right here in California. Will you promise to do that? Our children come first. Yeah. And keep that up. We have a primary election on June 3rd. June 3rd. That's less than 2 months away. Every person who knocks on your door, every person who sends you a piece of mail and says, vote for me, you need to contact them and say, will you take a pledge to put our students first, to put our schools first? And only then will you promise to give them the pledge of a vote for their political future. To all the families that are here, para todos los latinos que están aquí, gracias por su apoyo. Thank you for your support. We are a nation of diversity. We are a state of diversity. We know that education is the way we raise the level for everyone who comes here from all around the world, for the promise that is America, for the promise that is California. Thank you for being out here today. Keep this up. We need your voices. We need those 6 votes in the legislature to realize we need our schools, we need every teacher to succeed. And we can't say, leave no child behind and then cut the budget. It's nonsense. It doesn't make sense. Yes, we can. Please say, put it there. We're going to get the money we need for our schools. Are we going to go take back the legislature and get the funding we need for education? And put an end to No Child Left Behind and make sure everyone